Hello students of class 8. Students, today we are going to start with our new chapter, that is New Trends on World Wide Web. Students, today we will learn about e-commerce, m-commerce and net banking. Students, e-commerce, what do you mean by e-commerce? So, the buying and selling things and services using computer and internet is called as e-commerce. Students, do you know that suppose we want to buy anything, let's take a book. So if we want to buy a book from a website, so here we will take a website called Amazon. So we will buy this book, we will click on buy now. So what are the options that you will get? You will make payment for it. Like buyers make payments using various options like credit cards or debit cards and net banking. And online sites provide payment features where buyers can enter their payment details like card number or bank account number in a very secured way. Buyers also enter their address. Once the payment is done, the item is scheduled to be dispatched to the buyer's address and we get the item delivered at our doorstep. So, this buying and selling things and services using computers and internet is called as electronic commerce. So, whatever websites you see in your computer, wherever you buy and sell things, that are electronic commerce. And students, like nowadays we have advent of or we have a habit of smartphones. Like people prefer buying things with the help of mobile phones and other handheld devices. And this way buying involves the use of cellular mobile network. And students, buying and selling things and services over the cellular network and internet using your mobile devices is called as m-commerce. So the whatever apps you see, that are m-commerce. So students, for various products and services, many various kinds of apps are available. You can download these apps and sell or buy things using them. For example, using Snapdeal, Flipkart, Amazon, Meesho, these apps, you can buy a variety of networks and you can sell a variety of products. The most popular sources for apps to download are Google Play Store and even Apple App Store. So students, with these stores, we download apps to buy and sell things. And that apps are nothing but m-commerce. Nowadays, you don't have to stand in a long queues for depositing money in your accounts or withdrawing the money or buying anything or selling anything. You don't need to stand in a long queue. But because today in most of the transactions of money are very done easily from the comfort of your homes and whenever you want, like when we are walking or when we are traveling anywhere, you can buy it anytime. So this everything has been possible due to the very highly secure feature, and this highly secure feature is provided by the banks. And that is called as net banking. So students, see, security is a very big issue in online payments, right? Like our data can be taken by anyone or hacked by anyone. So what we have to do is, or what banks do is, the data is encrypted while it is transferred online. And this all encryption is done by the gathering the information. And this is done by the protocol, which is SSL. And students, SSL stands for Secure Socket Layers. So what does net banking do? Net banking allows us to connect with our banks using a very highly secure password
and access our account. And students making online payment or transferring money from one account to another is done very easily and securely using the net banking. And students, you know that to use these features, users go to the bank websites, they launch, or you can launch the mobile app to log in into their account, and all the e-commerce and m-commerce website allow to use net banking for making payments. And students, instead of net banking, you can take cash on delivery also. So this also comes in e-commerce and m-commerce. So students, I hope that you have understood about e-commerce, m-commerce and payment gateway or net banking.
What is digital marketing? Students, websites track our buying behavior and browsing habits in a various ways, like while we are online, and then they can reach us with specific kinds of advertisements or ads that are in our interest. And students, you might have seen that lot of ads and promotional messages are there while watching TV, right? Same way, advertisements are also found in newspapers and magazines. And also, we see this advertisement in the form of banners, posters, pamphlets in marketplaces also. But students, have you ever noticed that how do online sellers reach us to sell their goods and devices or services? So students, they use online medium to do so. And students, we receive very promotional mails in our email account, or we get messages, promotional messages in our messaging. And students, whenever we go online to use social media like Facebook, Twitter, we get a very variety of promotional materials and advertisements. Many ads are also displayed. So many times we get irritated, right, with these pop-ups while surfing the World Wide Web. This all are nothing but advertising, and this is nothing but digital marketing. So students, the process of reaching out to the people and customers with the information of products and services over internet, mainly through social media and email, is called as digital marketing. So students, whenever we buy something online, the sellers keep a track of our preferences or interests, whatever we are buying, these habits, and even our surfing habits, that is whatever we are searching, that habits, and then display us with the suitable investments and offers. And this is called as targeted digital marketing. And this form of marketing is very highly effective and beneficial for online sellers. This is a very suitable also and less distracting for people, as they can get those offers and advertisements in which they might be interested. So students, this is nothing but digital marketing.